Hello guys, what's up? So in this video series, I'm going to start developing color switch using pure JavaScript. So we'll just create a jumping ball which changes color on refresh. So let's get started. I have done some setup like linking files, linking our scripts of JavaScript. So first of all, I've linked the p5.js script which we are going to use for drawing on the canvas. Second, our sketch.js containing all the code to draw the sketches. And then we're going to have our player.js which is going to hold our player class which is going to control the ball. And in the sketch.js file, I already created some functions like setup and draw function to create our canvas. The canvas will be of size 400 by 500 and the function draw will draw a background 0, that means a black color. And also we have a mouse pressed function such that to implement clicks on the game such that the ball will jump on it. So this is the basic setup we need. Now in the player.js class, we have a colors class such that we can get any color we need. Any color in the RGB form, we are just returning a list of colors. So we are gonna pass this color directly into the fill and stroke functions when we need. You can find the code in the description below. These functions are static, so we can access them by just the class name, such that colors.pink will give us the color pink, and similarly will give us blue, red, green, and also a random function I've created which will return a random color from this list. If you want to add more colors, you just add these colors into the list and the function will take care of it. You just have to add the colors function in this list. Based on the size of the list, a random index will be generated and will be passed to the list such that we can return a random element whenever this random function is called. Now let's create a class player which will hold our attributes like position of the ball and the size of the ball, and we can draw this ball on the screen by using this class. We will call a draw function on it. So for the player, the x will be constant, that means width divided by 2. It will always be in the center of the screen horizontally. And vertically we will draw it little further than the center of the screen, so it will be height divided by 2 minus 20. We will have a draw function, and also as our ball is falling continuously and we are jumping, that means the ball has velocity and acceleration. So we will set velocity to be 1 and the acceleration also to be 1. So velocity will change our y position and acceleration will change our velocity, and this will make our ball fall down. And in the jump function, we're gonna just do the opposite, we'll reverse the acceleration. So first let's draw the ball. Now before drawing the ellipse, let's set the color to fill our ball. So we will fill the color, we will set the property of the player. So color will be randomly generated as the player object is created. So it will be a random color. So colors.random function we are calling, and it will return a colors array, RGB color, random color from the list we created, and it will set the color of the fill. And then we are gonna draw the ellipse. So basically, whenever you create the player object, a new color, random color is assigned to the player, and that colored ball will be drawn on the screen. And then we'll just draw the ellipse at this dot x, this dot y, and of width 60 and height 60, that means a circle. Now the draw function we created will just draw the ball statically on the screen. It will not move because we haven't included the velocity and acceleration into the game. So let's just create a player variable. And we'll initialize it in the setup function. Always remember to initialize variables in the setup function, because in draw we are calling draw function multiple times, but the setup function is called only once, which is good for initializations. And we'll just call the draw function on the player object that will draw our player or the ball on the screen. We have to say this dot color and not just color. This is a mistake I repeat again and again. So as we can see now, it's changing color on the refresh, because on the refresh we are creating a new object of the player. It is assigning a random color to the player ball and we are drawing it on the screen. That's it. Now the original game also has a functionality to change the color of the ball in the middle of the game. So let's create a function setColor such that we can pass in any color in the parameter that will change the color property of the object. Let's add gravity to the ball. So we will create a function update which will call in the draw function, which will update the position of the ball such that it will add gravity to the ball. So if you're following my channel, you have seen in the Flappy Bird video we have added gravity into it by doing this thing. So we'll just first limit the velocity, so the velocity won't be able to go up higher than the 5 value. So the velocity will be added velocity will be increasing with respect to the acceleration. Based on the acceleration, the velocity will increase, and based on the velocity, our y value will increase, such that giving us the movement effect. So this dot y plus equal to this dot velocity. That means moving our ball downwards, because when you add something to the y, you go down. As you can see, the ball is now falling down. Now we can create a function jump in the class player, which will make our acceleration negative, which will in turn make the velocity negative, which will make the y decrease. That means the ball will jump up. Now before creating the jump function, we have to ensure that we only jump once. So for that, we are creating a switch variable, that means a boolean variable. So whenever it is true, we will jump, and whenever it is false, we will not jump. So once we call the jump function, we will set it to true, and whenever the jump is done, we will set it to false. This will be clear to you in a while. So let's just create the jump function and set the once to true. That means we have initiated a jump. And then we will make our acceleration, which was positive, that means 1, to be negative 1, that means opposite of it. Now if you leave it right here, the acceleration will be negative and nothing will change it, so the ball will continue to move upwards. So we have to change this thing once we complete the jump in the update function. So in the update function, we'll check the condition if we are jumping or not. So if the switch is on, that means once is true, and also we are in the limits of our velocity, that means our velocity is not too much negative, so it's greater than negative 10. Because the acceleration is gonna decrease the velocity to its negative value, we just have to limit it. So if we are in the limits, we just have to add the acceleration, that means negative acceleration. This negative velocity will make our y decrease, that means going up, so the jump will be initiated in this thing. And also, if this is not the case and velocity is below this minus value, that means it's very much negative, we just have to reset everything and just have to continue the gravity thing. That means the ball will fall down. So we will set the ones to be false. We have set the jump, and then we will set the acceleration to be positive, which will in turn make the velocity go up and positive, which will make our ball fall down. We can call this jump function into the mouse pressed function, so whenever we click, we jump. Check it out. Now as we click on the screen, the ball moves up, that means jumps, and when we leave it, it falls down. So guys, that's it for this video. In the next video, we're gonna create obstacles and collision detections between the obstacle and the ball. So see you next time. Thanks for watching.